town, able just to relax, play basketball, meet a lot of people, and just be with my family. So that was great.
Just playing in the game, what was that like?
It was great. Playing in front of a lot of fans, like I said, in front of my family, to meet a lot of new people from other teams, finally be able to play with them, and just to kind of relax and just have fun and kick it.
Then just to get a few days on the back end of it, was that
kind of? Yeah, that was good. I actually went home, got a chance to relax, rest my body, see my family once again. Just chill and just do some stuff that got nothing to do with basketball, so that was good.
Do you measure yourself on a spectrum? I mean, you see all these guys in this rookie sophomore game and everything, and they're the cream of the crop. Do you, measure yourself in some respects by those guys?
Not really. I kind of, know where I want to be in the NBA. I think a lot of people, they start in different places, end up in different places, so I never want to measure myself according to somebody else, because, I think that everybody has their own path. So, as long as I'm just, elevating and getting better and just keep rising, I think that my progression is fine. And I think, I've done a good job of, learning and just keep getting better each and every day.
Josh, what do you think? I mean, what's the mindset for the team now coming out of this break, 25 games
Energy.
Left?
I know we got a lot of days off and everybody had their break, but I think it is good to, get guys back healthy. I think everybody's healthy now, so just to be able to have that energy and just to pull through these last about 25 games and be able to make a run for the playoffs.
I know you get a chance to kind of get away from basketball over the break, but do you use any of that time kind of introspectively to be like, okay, I'm doing this well, and here's what I can be better at?
Nah.
Shut your brain off.
Just shut my brain off.
Did you stick around for Saturday night in Charlotte?
Yes, I stood for Saturday night.
What did you think of the dunk contest?
It was cool, man. It was good to see. Hami was actually my teammate in USA Basketball, so it was actually good to see him win it. It's crazy because I remember one play, we were scrimmaging, and somebody missed the shot. He tried to put it back, but he missed, but he put his arm and elbow in the rim on a putback miss, and I thought that was insane. So to see him jump over Shaq and do it, that was even more insane. So, all props go to him, and I'm really happy for him.
I know there was a little bit of push locally for you to maybe do that one day. Would you be interested in ever doing
the dunk contest? I'd be interested. I was gonna do it this year, but my legs didn't agree with me, so I listened to my legs.
Ryan was talking about how just he's been looking at things over the break and like one possession, whether it's like in transition or making a stop or doing something can make a huge difference in the game. Is that something? I mean, when you start thinking about how to handle transition defense or get back and that kind of stuff. Is that something he started to talk about with you guys yet?
Well, yeah, I mean, that's just the rule of basketball. So a lot of plays may end up in the last second shot, but it's never the last play that, wins or lose a game. There's plenty of possessions before that you could have done. Maybe if you would have got the defensive stop in the first quarter, and then maybe they would have went on a run, or if you're able to, get the loose ball. So, I mean, it's just basketball. Everybody knows that, you got to make each and every play is important, because you might rest on a play in the first half or in the first quarter and early in the third quarter, but may not see the bigger scope of things or what that play could do for you in the last play of the game, because, maybe if you do one of those plays, you get two more points and you're up four instead of up two when they hit a three at the last second to win a game. So, I mean, that's all those possessions are huge. And, yeah, he has been preaching that every possession is precious, so you got to treat it like that.
He's been basically saying that he praised you the other night for your sticking to the game plan. It was kind of a gang guarding, but you also were the primary defender, so it required discipline and aggression. Is that something you think you've gotten better on as the course of the year has gone on?
Yeah, I think the biggest thing for me, my focus has just been to execute the game plan. A lot of times, I may, kind of forget them or kind of just deviate from them a little bit. But, I think as the season is going on, I'm getting better at, staying disciplined with the game plan and just executing it to the best of my ability. Thank you.
Thanks, Josh.